They prey on the vulnerable, exploiting the desperate in ways that can kill. Nigeria's fake physicians are taking a heavy toll on unsuspecting patients. Yet the authorities seem powerless to stop them, to identify the culprits, bring them to justice, and draw a line under their ruthless scams. Two African journalists go deep undercover into the disturbing world of quack doctors.
My name is Anas Aremeyaw Anas. I am an undercover journalist from Ghana. You will never see my face. Anonymity is important in my job because it protects me and gives me the power to be able to do one story after the other without being hurt by the bad guys. The bad guys in this investigation are fake doctors and sham hospitals, which have become a major problem in West Africa in recent years. Earlier this year in Ghana, I exposed the activities of one bogus medic who carried out abortions on vulnerable young girls and then had sex with them. Now I am joining forces with a colleague in Nigeria, where the problem is just as bad. We are going to shine a light on some of these sham hospitals and quack doctors and name and shame those involved.
My name is Rosemary Nwaebuni. I'm a journalist from Delta State, Nigeria, and have investigated the activity of fake doctors for years. I want to expose these criminals and bring them to justice.
On a daily basis, many lives are lost on account of wrong diagnosis and treatment by fake and quack doctors.
Plagued by chronic underinvestment and strikes, the World Health Organization ranked Nigeria's health system 197th out of 200. Many have few alternatives, and almost a quarter have been victims of quacks.
This quack is not just done in established private clinics or hospitals. Some even hide behind the pharmacy shop.
Fake doctors are a serious issue all over Africa. As director of the World Health Organization's Pharmacovigilance Center in Ghana, Professor Alex Zudu monitors drug and patient safety and has dealt with quacks for years.
These people are able to evade detection or reopen quickly for only one reason: lack of enforcement of existing legislation. Our ability to regulate is so weak that even when we know we should go to check every day, we don't have the personnel to go and check.
In my career, I've had many stories of girls suffering or dying from botched abortions at the hands of quacks. It infuriates me that these ruthless men keep getting away with it and the victims are too intimidated to speak out. I'm meeting a young girl who is too ashamed and frightened to show her face. She was pressured into having an illegal abortion done by a quack that left her disabled and unable to bear children.
I got pregnant from my boyfriend. When I told him about it, he was insisting that we should get rid of it. Then the doctor came to meet me. He inserted something in my private parts. He gave me, then after an hour, he gave me an injection. My right leg was really paining me seriously. I was unable to get up nor sit.
In a secret location, I meet a genuine doctor who has treated many victims of quacks and seen some die. He's willing to help us expose the charades fake doctors use to fool their patients. He's well known in this community and believes that some of the quacks could be vengeful and possibly dangerous, so we keep his identity hidden. In this investigation, we will call him Dr. John.
Some of the most common health problems we encounter with these patients ranges from misdiagnosis, complications from poorly prescribed medications. The most common of them is complications from abortion.
Unsafe abortions are Africa's dark, dirty secret. I want to shed light on this tragedy because so many women often have no choice but to risk their lives at the hands of the quack abortionist. Every year in my country, tens of thousands of them will die. Behind closed doors in every community, families are grieving for their daughters and sisters in silent rage. Rose is one of them.
My sister lost her life in the hands of a quack doctor because she went there to patronize them when she got pregnant and she wanted to get rid of it. She thought that is one of the easiest way for her if she go there to go and do their portion so that maybe her friends and family members will not be aware of it.
But the abortion done in a pharmacy went terribly wrong. It was Dr. John who tried to save Rosie's sister when she arrived at the hospital.
We had to take this patient into the theater. There was a ruptured uterus and the intestines were perforated. So at the end of the day, we could not salvage her life.
Yeah, please, doctor. Please, my sister gave me your number. I have a little problem that I want you to help me.
We tracked down Johnson Chukwudi, the quack who did the abortion on Rosie's sister. I will pretend I'm pregnant and let him examine me to see how far he will go. To protect his dirty business, he will not give us his address on the phone and instead sent us somebody to follow in our car. I want justice for this girl's death. It's time to go undercover. I believe that this man, Johnson Chukwudi, is responsible for the death of that young girl. Staring into his eyes, I'm gripped by fear. The pregnancy test is negative and I know I'm not pregnant, but he still wants to examine me. At the back of his pharmacy, he hides a dingy room where he operates on women who come to him. I'm so nervous. It's my first time undercover. At least Anas is with me, posing as my boyfriend. After a brief prod of my stomach, Johnson Chukwudi claimed he could feel a baby. Johnson Chukwudi has no medical qualifications. He's a quack, a fraud. He is lying so that I will pay for an unnecessary and illegal abortion. It could kill me. We say we will come back for the abortion, but we plan to bring the police to arrest him. At least I could walk away. Rosie's sister never had that choice. We are traveling to the family farm where she is buried in an unmarked grave. Even in death, she found no dignity.
That was her final year. She already finished her exams. And even while she was in the hospital, those things are still very fresh, as if she's sitting beside me.
Backroom abortions aren't the only quackery we uncovered. In our investigation, we found fake doctors who claim to treat all kinds of illnesses. Patients don't always see their trickery because the settings can look very credible. In this building called the Austin Royal Clinic, one fake doctor, Deacon Austin Aoto, seen here in the car, is getting away with an outrageous calm. But Anas plans to give him a dose of his own medicine.
Today, I'm on my way to Ole in the Niger Delta district. I'm going with three of my Nigerian friends. We are going to this doctor to find out how he operates.
The Austin Royal Clinic has all the trappings of a real hospital. Anas has brought three friends to see Mr. Aoto. He has no medical qualifications and he is masquerading as a doctor. We've heard he regularly diagnoses healthy people as sick. Our friends are in excellent health, as certified by our own genuine Dr. John, but they fake symptoms. Emmanuel pretends he has a sore head. Gladys pretends she is dizzy and has stomach pain. Chooks pretends he has been vomiting. Let's see what the bogus Dr. Aoto says. Aoto examines patients using a controversial and unlicensed device called the quantum resonance analyzer. He pokes them in different parts of the body with a metal rod attached to the machine. He claims that with it, he can diagnose a wide range of ailments instantly without any lab test. Incredibly, he tells our three healthy volunteers they are all suffering from life-threatening illnesses.
This is a case of typhoid and malaria.
Wow.
But his right eye, he has more of typhoid. He has more of typhoid. The right brain is affected.
Okay.
You don't need infusion. You only need good drugs. The drugs and everything, they are here.
After the test, Mr. Alto pushes her to sell them his drugs.
Let me give you 2,000. So tomorrow when I come, I will.
Okay, no problem.
There's no journal presented concerning this quantum resonance analyzer. It's a scam. It's a scam and sham. That's what I'll call it. And it's criminal.
The more we look into fake doctor scams, the more we'll realize how many there are. To reveal the scale of this problem, we are launching Operation Quack Attack. We invite three different suspected quacks to do a home visit. We've rented this house in Sample, southern Nigeria, and spent 2 days rigging it with secret cameras. If locals spot us and word gets out, our cover will be blown. Pretending to be the patients once again, I need to pull this off perfectly.
I will be lying down here on the bed. The doctors will be invited in to come and attend to me.
This time, Anas is playing the role of my concerned husband. Dr. John will be watching me on camera nearby. He has rehearsed me in the symptoms of a serious heart condition to test our target's medical knowledge.
Right here inside the ceiling is the secret camera.
We send for the doctors. I wait anxiously for what's in store for me. The first quack to arrive is Chris Emesakoro. I tell him my fake symptoms. Headache for 2 months, chest pain and leg swelling. Classic symptoms of a heart problem.
Doctor, so which place do you do your doctor?
I run a pharmacy shop, not a hospital doctor.
He just confirmed that he's not a doctor, that he runs a pharmacy shop.
The pharmacist ignored my symptoms of heart disease and instead diagnosed malaria and typhoid. As he is not a doctor, he should not be prescribing drugs.
This is absolute quackery. All he did was just look at the patient and prescribe medications for the patient to take, all barrage of medications for this patient to take with malaria and typhoid. This is wrong. This is all wrong. Drugs are not just to be taken anyhow. These drugs are poison. They have their own damage they cause to the body.
Our second fake medic arrives. She calls herself Nurse Charity. She also prescribed drugs illegally without even examining me. She also paid no attention to the symptoms of serious heart disease.
This prescription is inadequate. No trained medical practitioner would do this.
Our third target calls himself Dr. Saple, but again, he is not a qualified doctor and is not licensed to practice medicine, and his bedside manner could be improved too.
This is a very wrong way of abdominal examination. The way he just pounced on the abdomen of this patient is very wrong.
After randomly examining my stomach, he also dismisses my swollen leg, although it's a symptom of a heart condition.
So it is normal, the leg. The leg is normal due to our sleeping.
Way off mark, he wrongly diagnoses malaria.
What is wrong with him? It's malaria, please. Malaria.
This is a clear evidence of a quack.
What I actually experienced today is a clear exposition of what my people go through in the hands of the quack.
When you start looking, these quack doctors are everywhere. Nobody knows exactly how many people are dying at their hands. We took our evidence to the police. They set off to raid the pharmacy of the first fake doctor we met, Johnson Chukudi. But he was tipped off and evaded the authorities.
This is so disgusting. This is a man we have been looking for in connection with the death of Rose's sister, and he has been able to run away.
We won't give up. We are back on the hunt for quack abortionists and want to catch one in the act. I'm shocked to find women are also part of the network. Locals tell us about a ruthless husband and wife team in Sapele. This woman, Mrs. Ogboro, entices guests to come for abortions done by her husband in the filthy backroom of his beer parlor. I hate doing this, but I have no choice. I need to see if he will offer to do an abortion on me. Aigbe Ogboro has a reputation of aborting even in advanced stages of pregnancy, but he is not even a real doctor. His wife brags incessantly about his case, but her sales pattern makes my flesh creep.
Can why do you allow her to take this? I don't depend on you.
Without even doing a pregnancy test, I was shocked he was ready to carry out an abortion on the spot. I'm glad that my pretend husband, Anas, is with me.
So, if I charge you, I will charge you 50,000.
Madam, I want to know whether after that she will get the strength to walk.
Yes, ma'am.
We tell him that we will return tomorrow for the abortion. Providing nobody tips him off, we will be back with the full force of the law.
Jesus. How can somebody at this age be doing what he's doing?
We take our videos to Dr. Alfred Ebiakofa, senior medical officer working for the Ministry of Health. He's always lacked the resources to prosecute quacks. He agrees Aigbe Ogboro is a prime target. But before we raid him, Alfred wants to team up with us to get the proof about another fake doctor who is most likely to be tipped off. One of his long-term aims has been to shut down Royal Diktat Clinic in Warri, run by this notorious quack, Charles Iguodala.
He has a number of patients, and he will just come and start injecting all the patients with same syringe, same drug.
So far, Iguodala has eluded the authorities. But with Anas and his secret camera, they could finally catch him red-handed. Tomorrow, Alfred will lead the police raid.
We've not been able to catch him before. So what we're doing now is that we're going to that place and pick him.
Anas sketches out his plan. He will go into the Royal Diktat Clinic, posing as a patient complaining of chest and body pain. Once inside, he will allow the police to catch the quack Charles Iguodala syringe in hand. We set off. Anas goes in. The police take up station outside the clinic. Inside, Iguodala carries out his bogus examination. After a few minutes, Iguodala heads to the back room, presumably to pick up his dirty syringe. Terrified, Anas lifts off the bed and follows him. It's time for the police to pounce.
Doctor, wonderful doctor. Carry him.
The police force him to wear his stethoscope to publicly shame him as a fake doctor.
Say you are a doctor. Put it in your neck. Put it in your neck. Yes, I'm with you. I'm with you. Doctor.
Move now. They call him doctor.
Doctor.
With the quack in custody, we head back inside to collect the evidence.
Is that how things should be done?
Old syringes.
Yes.
He's using old syringes and needle.
What is there here? Behind here. What about those lines?
These are supposed to be drip lines. After you finish, you are supposed to discard.
Discard. Prescription. Stuff like that.
Okay. Let me see if I can get padlock somewhere so that we lock up this place completely.
At the police car, Charles Iguodala is claiming to be a doctor after all. He says he qualified in Bulgaria.
Do you have your certificates with you?
They are there. Where? In Bulgaria.
How can you get your certificates?
No, even if you study in Bulgaria, if you come to Nigeria, you must register with Nigerian Medical and Dental Council.
Iguodala was not able to prove he qualified in Bulgaria and is not licensed in Nigeria.
If the one is not licensed by the state, anything the one does is illegal. Going to see them is dangerous, period. You are working with someone. Would you sit in a plane, in an aeroplane, where the pilot says, okay, hello, I'm a pilot, but I've not been licensed? No way. You put your health at risk, you can die.
News of our raid spreads like wildfire, and Alfred wants us to move fast to catch our next targets. It's time for my abortion by Mr. and Mrs. Ogboro. She can tell I'm nervous and tries to reassure me. Anna pays for the abortion in marked bills. My fellow woman is selling me out and risking my life. She leads us to her husband's filthy operating room. My heart is pounding. Once Anas and I are inside, there is no way back. I'm moments away from the operation. He prepares the operating room. I'm so scared. Thank God the police get here on time. The fake doctor protests as the plainclothes police officer takes him away. The police have their man, and thanks to us, they can now prove his guilt. Sadly, this is rare. Without hard evidence, quacks can't be held accountable.
Yeah, they pay the money to her.
Okay, enter now. You enter. Enter.
They pay her. Give her now money.
Abortion money.
Abortion money.
No, where is my money?
That's the money.
They pay you.
Yeah, now look at.
They mark the money.
They mark the money.
We don't know.
They mark the money.
I find this entire raid very, very satisfying, very fulfilling. Because for the first time now, I have evidence to put these people away for good. And I'm going to use it.
These quack health practitioners now operate using pharmacy shops, clinics, and even the beer parlor. With the evidence we have established in the course of this investigation, we have been able to bring the culprits to justice.
I often ask myself how these quacks can live with themselves. At the police station, we want to confront them with our video evidence to see if they show any remorse. Unbeknownst to them, there is a bigger shock in store. This woman, Juliet, had a botched abortion by Aigbe Ogboro that almost killed her.
In that same place?
The same place now. Do you not know me? No, I can't even make it go of abortion. I take cut my intestine. As I wish, as I lately die, that God save me. This is my bust a womb.
Are you guilty as child? That is what we want to know. Are you the person who perforated her uterus or intestine? I'm asking you, sir.
No answer.
Very, very heartless. No one say get children. If they do this thing to your pikin, you go there very happy. And you too. You go there very happy because that you said your husband.
Shut up.
How do you go shut up? You feel not consigned. And I see they pay the money.
Quacks are the worst. Because they have no morals. They are not regulated. They cannot be held to account. They are itinerants. They move from village to village. They come and do it and run away. So we need to save our society. We need to save Africa.
My journey with Anas has come to an end. Although some quacks were tipped off and evaded our raids, we were able to apprehend two of the most notorious. Many more will fall victim to these quacks if the police don't have the resources to get the evidence themselves.
The evidence we have obtained is admissible in court and can stand the test of time. My mantra of naming, shaming, and jailing continues. It doesn't matter where you are. If you're a bad guy, I am coming after you.